This case was a mandibular case of immediate loading. The patient was quite old and she had a hopeless dentition, and her desire was to have an immediate substitution of her fixed teeth with something fixed. We discussed together about the possibility to obtain an immediate loading solution for her. So we started to study the case using dedicated software like Codiagnostic, where we uploaded the CBCT scan files, and we also uploaded the scanning of the models of the patient and of workup of the situation we want to obtain at the end with some references. In this software, it's possible to upload all this data and to have at the same time the position of soft tissue, the position of bone, and the desirable teeth that we want to realize. On this base, we can plan the implants in a very sharp position, prosthetically driven, and it's quite easy to look for the best quality and quantity of bone due to obtain a very high primary stability that, as we know, is a prerequisite for immediate loading. We also plan dedicated pins to stabilize the future guide to the existing bone, and everything was ready for the surgery in a few minutes of planning with these softwares. Then we send to the lab our planning and the guide we designed. The guide is realized to be fixed to bone because, as we have to elevate flap, extract the teeth, we cannot have a stability of the guide directly on teeth on the soft tissue. Thanks to this very good planning, the lab can provide for an immediate temporary bridge reinforced, and we will passivate this bridge directly in the mouth after the surgery. This is the situation of the panoramic X-ray, where we see the bridge. Now we can see the teeth that are completely lost. We start our surgery, elevating a flap for extracting the teeth and to adjust the bone level for receiving the implants. So we gently elevate the flap. We try to be as less invasive as possible because guided surgery has another advantage to maintain the invasiveness as less as possible, even if in this case it's not possible to have a flapless technique. We extract the remaining teeth, we remove the inflammatory tissues, and we modify the levels of bone on the base of our planning that we did before in the software. After elevating the flap, we have the need to stabilize the guide in the proper way, and you can understand that as we remove teeth and we remove some bone, we have not a good stability for the guide. So our goal is to have a stabilization on the guide, not on the mandible, but first of all on the teeth of the maxilla. So we will use some silicone tools to stabilize the guide to the maxilla, and then the guide to the mandible with dedicated pins. So in this stage, we are removing teeth, we are removing bone, we remove the pathologic tissues. We try to obtain a flat level in bone to have the better position for the implants. After this drilling, we set our guide in the right position. As we can see now, we try to have a stable position for the guide that is quite impossible directly on the mandible. So we use this silicone tool to keep it stable, make the patient close with the teeth of the maxilla. So we stabilize the position of the guide, and keeping the guide with teeth closed, we are able to have the good position, the planned position of the guide to drill for the fixation pins. We need to maintain in position the guide during all the process. Then we stabilize the guide to the mandible. And after these three pins, the mandible looks completely stable. And at this moment, we can trust in this guide for drilling. After fixation of the guide with these pins, we start drilling just following the protocol that the software provides for the clinician. So it's quite easy for all the clinicians to maintain the right position of drilling, the right depth, and we just follow the instructions. We have no direct control on bone, so we have to just follow the instruction. We cannot change anything in the protocol due to obtain what we planned before. We start, of course, with 2.2 rotary instruments with specific tools for reduction of the gauge, and then we will move on the base of the planned implant to 2.8 drills and to 3.5 drills. So we go on drilling with the last rotary instruments. As you can see in the video, refrigeratory, it's not very easy with a guided surgery to have a good irrigation into the sockets. So it's very useful to remove the rotary instruments after some drilling to be able to remove the debris and to allow the saline solution to irrigate inside the socket. After implant placement, we can remove the fixation pins, remove the guide, and we can adjust the level of the BLT implants to be sure to be completely inside the bony tissue. Because as you know, in this case, we extracted the teeth, we removed some bone, so even if we trust completely in the planning, we have the opportunity with an open flap technique to control perfectly the depth of the implant at the last moment, and we can control how much primary stability we have to perform our immediate loading technique. Then, in our experience, we use this technique. We use directly in the mouth the temporary abutment that are already covered by composite, and we use a bridge, a composite bridge reinforced with metal, and we passivate it directly in the mouth with flowable composite. In our experience, this technique is the safer and the most quick to obtain a very good passivation. So we make an intraoral polymerization of the flowable composite. At this moment, we can remove it and the lab will receive this bridge. They will replace some composite that is contaminated. They will refresh with new composite and make a better polymerization and then polishing of all the structure. But it takes around 1 hour or 1.5 hours, not more. So the complete time for this process, normally it takes hours. It doesn't take 1 day or 2 days or more days. So it's very comfortable for the patient. She waits in the office just a couple of hours and she can have the delivery of the prosthesis after really a very short time. We will make the final adjustment in occlusion to be sure to have a distribution of loading in all the units. In the following days, we will check again the occlusion, because in this class of patients, when we change the occlusion situation so fast with anesthesia, we cannot be sure that the initial adjustment is the final one. So normally we control patient a day after day, the first week, 2-3 times in the first week, and then we can control again in the following weeks. In our experience, after around 2 weeks, we reach the final position and we can be sure to maintain this position during all the stage of the temporary, that it normally takes 3 months. Guided surgery is a good option to transfer into surgery our planning. Every time we have a good planning and then we go with a free hand in the surgery, it can be very frustrating, because very easily we modify from our planning to the real situation. It's very easy to lose the better position of implants or the better inclination of the implants. The second option to use guided surgery is to use a better amount of quality and quantity of bone during the implant drilling. Another very good side in using guided surgery is to provide for a temporary restoration before the surgery and have the need of just little adjustments and passivation into the mouth of the patient at the end.